In the city of Jamshedpur, Mr. Kajal does not need an introduction. As everybody knows, he is the group director, Global Minerals for Tata Steel.
I just want to tell you, I am
student
of this
institute.
That was more than enough, and I was just hoping that I'll be able to intercept Professor Madhukar before he does anything like that. It's quite an honor for me to be here in this hall, because Father Prabhu taught me. And also, I had seen just now one of my old favorite teachers, Father McGrath. He seems to have just left. It was a pleasure to meet him here. After so long. Just a few days back when I received this invitation from Father Abraham, I was quite happy to receive it. I felt very honored to be part of this, to join this festival of philanthropy. But little did I realize that I had fallen into such an august collection of people who have been associated with this till Mr. Madhukar sent me a little bit of history about this. And as someone has said, this keeps reminding me that the best use of life is to spend it for something that will outlast it. Something which you do which can outlast your life is probably the best thing to do in your life. And things like these, joy of giving and giving, it all reminds you of people like Mother Teresa and others. And you remember them, not for how they died, but how they lived. Not for what did they gain in life, but what did they give. So this is something which kept coming to me. And I was wondering how I should express my feelings. And I, of course, did some reading about people who have contributed a lot of their mind to the society. Came across some very good points and some special aspects of giving, and I thought I'd share with you. As I said, there's no need to travel a distant land or search out less fortunate. All we need is to awaken, to become aware of those around us. Every encounter is an opportunity to give. Our siblings, our spouse, children, friends, neighbors, workers, subordinates, bosses, everyone. These are all the people that we meet, and they'll all be very grateful to accept whatever we give, in whichever form. And these are, of course, this has a more spiritual aspect to it than physical, than what it doesn't cost. You give in many ways, in many forms. Sometimes in life we forget how much we can offer just by being patient and understanding, by not being indifferent. How much we can offer by not being indifferent and using our gift of recognition. Because a little recognition, a little understanding can boost the confidence of the person that we are encountering or that we are trying to give, and really make them brighten up. So some of these things I would urge the young students going into life to remember. Don't hesitate to give, don't hesitate to recognize people on the smallest possible opportunity. Give a pat on the back and you'll see the results of that. It's fantastic and outstanding results you get. I'm reminded of a story of a teacher. It was a Thanksgiving day and she was teaching first grade students, still a young children. And she asked them to draw whatever they were thankful for. She thought these little children from poor neighborhood actually had to be thankful for food. So some of them had to draw a turkey or something, a food item or something. Someone might draw clothes, lovely, nice looking clothes which they couldn't afford. But she was quite taken aback when a small child came up with a picture which just showed a simple hand. So she asked, whose hand? I think it must be the hand of God that brings us food, one child said. A farmer who grows food. Finally the teacher went to this child and asked whose hand it was, Douglas. He mumbled, it's your hand, teacher. And then she remembered and suddenly thought that, and she recalled that frequently at recess she had taken Douglas, a scrubby, forlorn child, by hand as something which she often did with all the new entrants to the school. So this is the kind of response that you would get when you try and help or serve a gift to people. It's quite fascinating to, see the span of this festival of philanthropy, from schools to corporates, from close donations to orphan donations. But there are a few things which I read and I think I must share, which would be useful. And the first one is from the great visionary J.N. Tata. That's what he said. What advances the nation or communities as to lift up the best and the most gifted, so as to make them of the greatest service to the country and the people? So he says, I prefer the constructive philanthropy which seeks to educate and develop the faculties of the best of our young men. And I'm sure that's what XLRI does. There's another aspect of giving which I think you should remember. And it was quite nicely put up by Reverend Gordon Powell. He said, he started with a story and said, an elderly stranger who appeared one day at a hospital in Petersburg, New Hampshire, saying, I know you must have many odd jobs, need doing, let me help. For 4 months, he performed countless menial tasks, sweeping the parking lots, building ramps, removing lint from the laundry, etc., etc. Once he was asked his name by one of the co-workers, he smiled and shook his head and said, if you knew who I am, you would feel obliged to feel obligated. And that would spoil it all. So let's not discuss that. He kept working and after 4 months he left. Once he went away, the hospital came to know that he was the former vice president of Pennsylvania Railways. He went there and he just did the work without telling anyone. And this is what Reverend Gordon Bowles said, that it's a very difficult art and it needs to be cultivated to serve without expecting any recognition for what you are doing. And you should be able to do without anonymously, without disclosing. And that's probably one of the good forms of doing service. Another point he made was, in our eagerness to help, we sometimes fail to recognize how embarrassing our gift may be to the sensitive, or how heavy upon the recipient may seem the obligation of gratitude. So one must give with sensitivity and sometimes anonymously. The last thing I would mention is, he asks something which is very well articulated by Gibran. He says, you give but little when you give of your possessions. You give but very little when you give of your possessions. It is when you give of yourself that you truly give. Thank you very much for inviting me. They say one of the greatest services you can offer is your time, because that is something non-renewable resource for you and most precious. So do give whatever time you can give for the service. I am really thankful to be here. I wish this festival inspires everyone around here and everywhere to carry this joy beyond this week and makes it an inseparable part of our lives. Thank you very much for this.